just got the, basically the results of my MRI back. I mean, the results were, there's no cancer, which, you know, kind of like, duh. But I just talked to my doctor who interpreted the results. Basically, I have something called lymphedema, which I had kind of, you know, when nobody knew what was going on, and I hadn't heard anything, the last couple nights I've done a boatload of research on the internet, just looking up breast swelling after breast swelling with cancer, breast swelling after chemo, edema in the breast, that kind of thing. Just trying all these different searches to try and find something. And I did find the term lymphedema. However, it usually occurs in the arm because it has to do with the lymph nodes, and so it affects the arm. Mine is affecting the breast, and nobody knows why. It's a very rare occurrence, and apparently there's nothing you can do about it. And it may last forever. There's a very high chance that it will never go away. And I'm about in tears. It's kind of like in this day and age, they can't do something, you know, other than surgically altering one side or the other. I mean, she's talking about mastectomy to remove it completely. But, you know, it's like, oh my God, you know, I don't know. So nobody ever talked about lymphedema before my surgery, before my lumpectomy, before they took out the lymph node, before the chemo, before the radiation. I went back through all of my notes. The word lymphedema never appears anywhere. And when I was doing my research, it does say, I forget what site it was, if it was WebMD or Johns Hopkins, one of the actual medical sites was saying that quite often, you know, it's something that happens in a very few percentage of people. So a lot of times when you're under, you know, when you're first diagnosed with cancer, it isn't something that they tell you about because they figure that you're so overwhelmed, they being the medical staff, figured that you're so overwhelmed with everything else, they're not gonna give you the, this might happen this percentage of the time kind of stuff. And so, but this can happen, obviously, because I'm living it. And so my options, she's going to refer me to occupational therapy, but she doesn't think they can do anything because it's in the breast. If it were in the arm, there would be exercises. I could wear a compression sleeve, but because it's in the breast, there's nothing they can do about it. But she's going to refer me to occupational therapy to see if maybe they know something that she doesn't know. So I'm gonna have therapy bills. She's going to refer me for a prosthesis for the other side to match this side. So I'm gonna have a prosthesis charge. And I've got my notes. She wants to refer me back to my surgeon to do a punch biopsy. I don't really want to do another biopsy. I know there's no cancer there, but I guess I'm going to talk to the surgeon when they call to make the appointment, or the whoever. But you know, I don't really see a need for a biopsy at this point. I guess it depends on what the biopsy can tell them. I'll have to talk to the surgeon and find out what is in, you know, what's in it. She says it's a punch biopsy, which just takes a little skin sample. It's not a needle going in. They don't have to do that big click click machine thing. That's pretty much it. I don't know. I was getting ready to film another video today, and about finances, because I'm at the end of my rope there as well. My dog is having surgery in a few days, and I have to come up with $1,100 for that. My car has to have a safety inspection, which the safety inspection is only $25. That's not such a big deal, but it has to have a repair done before the safety inspection will pass, and that's going to be a couple hundred dollars. This all has to be done within the next week, and you know, on top of that, I've got other bills. I've got my car payment coming up. I've got my student loan coming up. I've got just, you know, like things like the car insurance and the credit card bills, the medical bills. I'm overwhelmed at this point, and I want to run away and just not do anything. So I was going to make a video about finances and maybe how you can prepare, like I didn't, or thought I was prepared and wasn't. And so yeah, I want to make a video going over finances more. I've talked about them a little bit, but I think it's something that really does deserve its own video, because they are so important, because if you're like me, you can lose everything. And so for now, I've got this, and I will update you on this as it happens. And I just got off the phone with my oncologist, so I haven't even digested it yet. But I wanted to make it while I was still in this. I wanted to make the video while I was still in this flux kind of thing, because that's how you're going to be if you get this news. And if your breast does start swelling, or your arm, you know, if something starts swelling, contact your doctor right away. Do not wait. I did contact my doctor within a week, but nobody knew what was going on, and so it's taken a month or more. Actually, more. It's taken close to 2 months. And so push your doctor. Do your own research. Don't let it go, because otherwise you could end up, you know, 2-3 cup sizes larger on one side than you are on the other, or your arm could get infected. There's something about a risk of infection if you don't take care of it right away. So, you know, if you heed anything in this video, heed that, you know, take care of it right away. And if you don't get the answers from your own doctor, then go on the internet and find something, because, you know, God knows. Anyway, I will update you when I get more information, and I'll put together that other video about finances. And so if you have any comments, if there's anything else you'd like to see, put it down below. And as always, hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't, and hit that little notification bell to make sure you get notified when new videos come out. Bye-bye.